So let's start in Toppy. I'm not sure, but it's okay. Everything lecture by lecture I'm uploading. हाँ, so we can start now. Our today's topic is going to be entropy. But as I said, students used to be confused between enthalpy and entropy. So I have to explain little bit revision. For enthalpy, symbol is H, and entropy, symbol is S. So physical feel about enthalpy. How will you feel enthalpy? Enthalpy is nothing but a type of energy. What type of energy it is? Suppose you have any section in which flow is happening. So at any section, you can have three types of energies. One energy is because of kinetic energy. One energy is because of the height. I mean that gravitational potential energy. And enthalpy is another type of energy which is associated with the fluid. Now, if you will go to detail of the enthalpy, then imagine in this way, if you have any chamber, then in this chamber you will be having certain volume, and in this chamber you will be having certain pressure. So if you multiply pressure and volume, and gases will be having their internal energy as well. So internal energy, when you add with the product of pressure and velocity, sorry, volume, then you get a new quantity that is called enthalpy. So this enthalpy is nothing but U plus PV. Okay, this is the first fundamental idea about enthalpy. So enthalpy is clearly energy, like heat, clearly energy, work, energy, enthalpy, energy. But entropy is not energy. So what is entropy? So let's understand what is entropy. See now. Suppose you are imagining that there is a point. Suppose there are three points, and in this system, this is the initial state. Initial state. Okay. Before starting entropy, you should understand a word. That word is order and disorder. Disorder. What is order? What is disorder? Imagine you have a playground, one for cricket and another one for football. So when you are talking about cricket, then the players will arrange in this way, like bowler, batsman, then umpire, then some positions are there. Before starting the match, you will be having a particular position of the like international match I am talking, of the players. Then in football, you will be having one goal here, one goal here, and footballers will be arranged according to their respective positions. So see, before starting the match, players will set themselves in a particular order. So right now what you are seeing in the cricket field, these people are arranged in their orders. In same way, football players are also arranged in their orders before starting the match. Now imagine if you are comparing cricket players with football players. I mean, if you compare this order with this order, they will not match. Cricket match, you cannot start in this order, right? And football match, you cannot start in this order. It means what? If you are talking for the football match, then this fielding is in order. If you are talking about cricket match, then this fielding is in order. But these both are disorder for each other. Now, another example to understand this. Suppose you have a classroom. In this classroom, there is a rule that left side girls will sit and right side boys will sit. Suppose there is another classroom. In this classroom, rule is first girls will sit and then in the back side boys will sit. Or suppose there can be another classroom. In this, first girl, then boys, then girls, and then boys. So see, this is also one order, but mutually they are disorder for each other. I mean, this class cannot run if students will sit in this pattern or in this pattern. According to this class, your order should be like this if you want to run this class. if you want to run this class, then this is not the order. So I mean to say that when you say there is something called disorder, then disorder is nothing but a respective term. You are in disorder with respect to a particular order. Guys, is that clear about order disorder? Okay. Now see, if we understand what is order and what is disorder, then let's understand the same example in thermodynamics. How to understand the same example in thermodynamics? So see, imagine the first classroom what I have done here. This is the closed chamber. And these are the molecules inside, red color and green color molecules. This is the initial condition. Just imagine, this is the initial condition. And you are supplying 50 joule heat. So when you are supplying 50 joule heat, then imagine this will be your new order of the molecules. And we are considering this system is ideal system. Ideal system means no losses, no friction, nothing is present which makes this system irreversible. It means this is reversible system. Already we have taken lectures on this. Already we know ideal things are reversible things are ideal things. So I am saying that I have supplied 50 joule heat, and after the supply of 50 joule heat, I found that I got this arrangement. Okay, so this became my order. But imagine this was the ideal case. But imagine if the same system, you supply same 50 joule heat, but in real life, then definitely you are not going to get the same arrangement. You will be getting some different arrangement. It means this arrangement and this arrangement, they are not same. Guys, just 1 minute, I'll put my camera in. Yeah, done. Yeah, okay. So see, if you take this arrangement and this arrangement I was expecting, and it was happening only in case of real or ideal case, but this arrangement I am getting when I am really doing the process. So here I am getting one order, here I am getting one order. So this guy is disorder. I mean, this arrangement is coming because of disorder. So we are going to, why this disorder is coming into picture? Why the real life pattern is not equal to the ideal pattern? Because of irreversibility present in the system when you are talking about the real process. What do you mean by irreversibility? It is nothing but friction. You know, so many causes are there. Many, two strong causes, you understand. Heat transfer and friction. These two are the strong causes for, as a thermodynamics student, these two will be, regularly you'll be facing these two challenges. Heat transfer and friction. It means, if you are talking about the chamber, in real life, whenever you will make the chamber, without friction, it is not possible. Friction will be there for sure. If you're talking about the piston cylinder arrangement, your piston will move up and down. Of course, there will be friction. So what is the key point here? Key point is, in your real life, irreversibility is present. Question is, what is irreversibility? Irreversibility is something because of that you are not behaving like ideal system. Who is causing irreversibility? Heat transfer and friction, they are main two causes I am discussing. Other than that, all the 5-6 causes I have given you already. For example, hysteresis, resistance, magnetic field, these people are disturbing you. But mainly, consider only two causes, heat and this thing, friction. So, if in your system, these two people are present, heat transfer and something, then definitely your system is no more reversible, it is irreversible. So, if you are reversible, then you are getting arrangement as the first chamber. But if you are irreversible, it means real system, then you are getting the second system. So first system and second system, first arrangement will not match with the second arrangement. So this is the ideal case. This is the real case. So if you'll match your real situation with the ideal situation, it will not match. So now see, guys, how much is not matching? How will you know? How much is not matching? So you can see this diagram and this diagram, they both are not matching each other. So you need a new quantity. You need a new quantity to find out how much irreversibility is present in the system, which is making phenomena disorder. So you should create a new quantity. That quantity is entropy. So what is entropy? In every textbook you will find that very popular statement. I will write here. Entropy is nothing but measurement of, now see here, what is entropy? It is nothing but measure or measurement of, you can see, disorderness in real process, or you can say irreversibility in real process. So this is called entropy. It means if your process is ideal, then you will not be having any irreversibility, then you don't have disorder, then your change in entropy is zero. Your change in entropy is zero. I will explain something, keep in mind. Entropy is, first thing, point function. Point function. For example, pressure, volume, they are point function. Entropy is also point function, symbol is S. Imagine you have a system. In this system, molecules are like this. Suppose, say, same system, but molecules are like this now. So for this arrangement, you will be having your separate entropy S1. For this arrangement, you will be having separate entropy S2. And because entropy is the measurement of the disorderness, so here where you have disorderness, from which diagram you will compare this? So you will compare this diagram when our universe got the structure that time. That time, whatever molecules I am drawing here, they were not here. They are actually coming from Big Bang. So whatever entropy we are measuring, this entropy we are measuring from zero entropy. It's like when we are not at all considering our anything, arrangement, any order, that time we consider entropy zero. From that level, we are measuring this entropy. So that's why we should say S1 minus zero, but no need to say zero, because we'll keep in mind, okay, this order is actually from the first time in the universe. From that time, so we consider S1. So how easily we can understand this? You'll be having a system. In the system, you'll be having arrangement. So for this arrangement, you'll be having entropy. Okay, now you'll be having another system. In that, you'll be having another arrangement. For this also, you'll be having entropy. So if you want to know, if you want to apply this concept in thermodynamics, how will you apply that? Okay, you have any system, in that your arrangement was like this, you supplied heat. So ideally you are expecting this, but in reality you got this. So why in reality you are getting this diagram? In reality, why are we not getting this diagram? This is the initial, after supplying the heat, ideally and really we got these two. So how much change in the order? It means how much disorder is there? So how will you find out? S2 minus S1. So this del S is the change in entropy, which is nothing but the measurement of disorder. How much irreversibility is there? Measurement of irreversibility in real process. Guys, concept clear? Dhruv and Gaurav? Okay. Gaurav, clear? Any doubt? What is entropy? So see, if I will say that measure your disorderness, suppose this is one order and it became like this. So what will you measure here? What will you measure? Will you measure the length? Will you measure the gap? No, that is gap. If you are measuring gap, then gap is gap. It is not entropy. I am saying you to measure the entire difference what you are seeing. I am saying you to measure disorder. So you cannot choose a quantity that is called length. Length you cannot choose, because length will give you gap. You cannot find out area, like, because area itself is a quantity. So to measure this kind of situation where order itself is not matching with another order, it means the disorder. We use entropy term. So we have introduced entropy term in the second law. So now you have to understand. Okay, now entropy is very well clear. So this much is about entropy. Now we'll understand who like how to formulate the entropy. So we have two very important ways. One by one, we will understand properly. So